Hello, let's talk a little bit about SSE, or the Security Service Edge. Now, SSE is really a subset of SASE, or the Secure Access Service Edge, that Gartner defined back in 2019. Now, SASE represented the convergence of networking and security delivered as a cloud-native service. SSE takes the security and zero trust network access capabilities of SASE and splits it off. Now, what this means is that existing capabilities that you're probably familiar with, like secure web gateway, firewall as a service, cloud access security broker, data loss prevention, remote browser isolation, and zero trust network access are all part of SSE. Now, what's changed really is the way that these are delivered, right? These capabilities aren't necessarily new. It's the way that they're being consumed that has changed with SSE. Now, the reason behind this is the digital transformation that has been upon us lately, and COVID-19 has definitely complicated things. What we see now is users are becoming more mobile than ever, working from multiple devices. They want to work from home, the airport, Starbucks. Really, it doesn't matter where they are, as long as they can access the resources that they need to get their job done securely. Now, additionally, organizations are moving their resources outside of their data center, right? They're now moving into the public cloud, and this could be, you know, Azure, AWS, GCP, or it could be SaaS services that are replaced on-premise applications, including things like Workday, Office 365, and Salesforce.com. Now, the main difference between SASE and SSE is that SASE has a focus on the security as well as the connectivity, including things like SD-WAN, network optimization, and things that improve performance. Cato is taking a different approach, and our SSE 360 has the best of both, right? You can buy SD-WAN and SSE 360 from us for a full SASE experience, or our SSE 360 allows you to use the security and zero trust network access capabilities, but with the high performance of our WAN optimization and global private backbone. Now, the real benefits here to customers is really the agility of deploying the service. Not only do they benefit from being able to offer security and access in much more locations than they would be able to on their own, global presence, right? Cato has 75 plus points of presence, and it's very typical for SSE and SASE vendors to have multiple points of presence. So this reduces latency, but also increases and improves localization for users. But beyond that, instead of having to buy hardware and wait for it, which I'm told it's, you know, 12 to 18 months from a lot of vendors due to supply chain issues, you no longer have to do that, right? You don't have to do that. You don't have to send specialized people somewhere to rack and stack hardware. It's entirely consumed as a service, and you can, you know, buy additional licensing as needed and add the capabilities that you want. On top of that, SSE vendors manage the updates for you, right? So you no longer have to worry about having multiple firewalls that could be on different security update versions, different firmware versions, and really creating an inconsistent security posture. Instead, you get, you know, a single console, a single set of application policies that you can use to control everything. And on top of that, you can be sure that your service is updating for you multiple times a day on your behalf. You no longer have to worry if the latest threat will affect you. You can, you know, be assured that you're up to date and ready to go. So thank you so much for watching this video on the Security Service Edge. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.